Right, here we go. Inside the engine bay, the WRX, we've got a intercooler with plastic on the side. Now surely plastic on intercoolers is not good or efficient. Certainly doesn't look that good. So I have got another top mount which I bought, so we're going to try and fit it. First we'll strip this one out, then we'll have a look at the new one, then we'll see if it fits. This pipe, the inlet hose looks a nightmare to get to. Obviously the one with the blue dot, that's where we got to get to. So that looks to be the biggest worry so far. But we'll start stripping it down and see where it leads to. Right, so this is what we're hopefully replacing it with. Seems to look similar, right sort of angles. I have bought this hose, cost me a fortune. It's the old Mishimoto one. Thought I might need it. And obviously the O-ring out of there is not gonna fit the new one. This didn't come with anything. 51mm by 2mm. If you need to get one. And obviously that fits onto the turbo. Now this is why, when you Google turbo for WRX08, this is why they say that it has to be VF52 and you can't fit any other turbos. It's simply because of this flange here on the turbo. It's just standard on this model, and obviously it bolts up to that part of the intercooler. I'm sure there'd be a way around it one way or the other. Probably, thinking out loud here, you'd probably make a flange to go on there, just a hole, and hose it over, I'd guess. But this is why people say you can't just swap a simple turbo. So that's the reason there, and this hose is just crazy to get to, look. So I'd like to put the blue one on, but realistically, without stripping everything out, I can't see how I'm going to reach the Jubilee clip on it and find the screw for it. So we'll try that one first. It's like unless you take the inlet manifold off. That comes with its own problems, look. It is connected to the inlet manifold, but I don't really want to start undoing all them bolts, taking all this out, just to change a hose. So if that works, then we'll leave it on. And if ever we do change the turbo and do a bigger build, then we'll upgrade it. But at the minute, standard boost, I'm sure it's fine. So there's a bit of a size difference. So let's just offer it up and see what the chances are of it fitting. So without too much trouble, we got it in to a degree. That hose does fit. So I've got the blue one, which I'll look right to at some point. Up there, that costs 50 quid. But we'll keep it. Obviously we'll use it at some point. And I'm not lining up here yet, but I think if I tighten this Jubilee clip here onto the inlet down there, get that tightened up, try and maneuver those flanges to line up, and if we fit our recirc valve back on, which is a chance that could go, look, anything we've got to do is then try and get this bracket organised, which may well go with a bit of bending. Be a bit of a bugger to bend, so it's got a lip on it, but we could cut it, cut the side and bend it in. But let's try and just get it connected up first. So all being well, it's looking possible at the minute, and I've only been on it 5 minutes, so maybe a quick one. We shall see. Right, there's always blood involved, isn't there? Always bloody involved. But I think the main battle is getting these two bolts off the turbo lined up. Now, the way I did it, just in case anyone's watching this, I'm just trying to fit one of these things. So the hose is fine. There's enough meat on that to grab it. Can't see. There you go. So the hose is on. I think I can pull that in as best I can. Now the way I did it, get this front bolt in first, and then you've got to twist the intercooler that way into the air intake hose. And then once you got that, you've got to try and get that back one in, which is a bit of a sod, but get your hand on here, lean off the wall and just push it, twist it down as hard as you can. Now obviously I might be jumping the gun because I've not got these tightened up, but nothing's cross threaded, it's all going well. So tighten these up, and then we're just going to have to check the inlet hose. If it does become a problem, oh hang on now, it's not going in anymore, look. Right, let's put some pressure on it, see if we can get it turning. I've got to be careful, so do not want to strip, obviously, the turbo, which would be a disaster. It's a tight hole, look. It's difficult to get it right. But let's put that pressure on, just see. I just twisted it, didn't I, and moved it, so. See if I can get that line back up without the camera. And I'll be back at you when that bolts in.
Do you think it's quicker than a knee right now?
Bloody hope so, Bab. Right, there you go. You got them bolts done up. Bit dodgy. But we got there. Don't go too mad on them, it's all flat. Looks like there's a bigger gap there in between it and the camera than there is, but there isn't. So they're the worst ones, get them in. Recirc valve was easy enough to get back on. The mount line's back up. I've dropped a bolt though, so that's in the tray underneath the car. I should find that, get a rubber or something to go on there. And hopefully the inlet's done up nicely. It doesn't, I don't know how much is on there, I just don't know. The clamp did up, so we can only assume that we got it sorted. So we'll take it up for a spin in a minute, start it up, or at least start it up, and see if we've got any leaks. Hopefully not. And there you go.
I want to go in.
That's a nice little easy go.
I want to go in it.
Go where?
In there.
In where?
In there.
What's it called?
The Scooby.
The Scooby, that's right. Okay, let's get sorted then, and we'll go and test it out.
Did you
say bye?
Bye!